This timber frame, dating back to the early 17th century, has been in this location for some 400 years and has been subject to weathering over that period. The rain which runs down the face of the building would collect near the base, and so the sole plate and the base of the uprights are the most vulnerable to water attack, to fungal attack, to beetle attack, and to general erosion. Once a decay has occurred to the point where the structural integrity has been lost, then repairs are necessary in order to safeguard the building's stability and its capability to provide a weatherproof envelope. In this instance, the decay at the lower levels, the sole plate, had involved loss of some of the timbers, and the lower part of the corner post had lost its linkage with the sole plates and the horizontal members of the timber frame. The complicated series of joints involved transferring the load back down to the ground, but avoiding the twisting actions which the building can be subject to. The corner post has to accommodate movement in two planes, and so this scarf joint has been designed to be able to provide the retention of the repaired piece by means of the housings to avoid the twisting, and to be able to get it into a sole plate, we've dug out so that it can be offered back up to the original timber frame, and then the other component parts put in place in the relevant sequence. You will notice that the housings for the joint are angled so that the loadings, once they come back down onto the repaired sections, are retained in place and avoids any tendency to flip out or move from the alignment of the original frame. These joints and the repaired sections, whilst they have this technical retention within the design of the joint, are also glued into position using waterproof glues, so that the whole structure, once it's put back in place, will reinstate the whole sort of linkage of this section of the building to the remainder of the structure, and so once more give it back its structural integrity. The carpenter spends time, skill and patience in ensuring that the interface of the new and the original material is as tight as possible, and that means that the joint can resist water getting in at any future date, and so ensuring that the repair is durable and will continue for many years to come. Technical restoration manuals exist which give clear illustrated guidance on how to repair and join timber, with specific reference to accommodating material in compression, in tension, and also those elements subject to twisting movement. The most difficult element of protecting a timber frame from the weather is the intersection between the timber frame and the infill panels. Traditionally, the wattle and daub allowed any moisture which was absorbed from the rain and damp conditions to be conveyed back to the outside through the natural porosity in the materials. Where we have brickwork, a soft brick and a soft lime mortar will still perform that function. However, in the 20th century, a common practice was to repair timber frames using a dense cement mortar. That is impervious to the free passage of moisture, and so as happens, moisture gets in around the edge of the timber frame, it's actually held in place by the cement. And the cement is inflexible, and as the timber frame moves over time, the panels themselves stay rigid. And we can see the movement and the fact that capillary action of moisture will go into the frame, and then the rot occurs. We can see the sequence where there's been a repair to the brick panels, cement has been applied to the brickwork has moved, further cement has been added around the edge of the frame, that has moved itself, and we can see where moisture gets in and where it can be trapped. And on the close-up, we can see that the capillary action of moisture going in has actually created pockets where the rot can occur, and then the cycle of degradation accelerates. For the repair panel, we've chosen a brick which closely matches the original, but this time, as was the case with the original construction, we're using a soft lime mortar, and this will allow any moisture that gets in around the edge of the timber frame to come back out to the outer surface and so evaporate and not be held against the edge of the frame, which causes the rot and decay and the type of repairs that we're having to undertake here today.